Hey everybody, it's Peter from Brantford Kia, and today we're talking about the 2019 Kia Sedona L. Now, why are we talking about the L model? This is our entry-level minivan, and minivans got really expensive, but ours didn't, and there's a whole bunch of reasons to buy ours over some of the competitors, and we're gonna talk about that right now. Let's go take a look. All right, let's talk about a few things just to get it off the table. First of all, people are wondering about reliability of minivans. Let's go right off the top. This vehicle, for 2018, so that's the latest results in from Consumer Reports. The Kia Sedona is the most reliable minivan. Now, if you're wondering about the least reliable, I know you're thinking Dodge Caravan, maybe something like that. Actually, Honda Odyssey is the least reliable minivan. So whenever we talk to people who are shopping for this van, they always talk about, you know, other brands, they want reliability and that kind of thing. No problem, we have the most reliable minivan. Simple as that. And every other dealer with every other brand, when they're telling you their minivans are reliable, that may be true. They may be very reliable minivans, but they're not the most reliable anymore. And all of the things that they use to convince you that their van is reliable, all of those studies are telling you that this one's really reliable as well. So people argue with me online about reliability. I don't really want to have that argument. I can just point to the facts. Consumer Reports, most reliable minivan. There you go, it's right behind me. So now that we got that off the table, let's talk about things. First of all, $35,000 for a minivan is basically where our competitors start. That's where Toyota and Honda are starting. That's where Dodge is starting with their Pacifica. Here we are, we're under $30,000 for this. So what do you get for that? A lot of options, a lot of features. First of all, I'm gonna start with talking about the 2019 model. Now there's a few things here. Again, base level, no options, no nothing on this vehicle. And you have a little bit different grille design here for 2019. If you're not a huge Kia fan like myself, you probably won't notice that difference. But there's been a couple updates. And if you see this grille design, you may notice projector beam headlights. But what it means is for 2019, the real difference that you're gonna notice is it now comes with an 8-speed transmission. It used to come with a 6-speed transmission. So the 8-speed transmission gives you power throughout, helps with the fuel economy, helps with a whole bunch of things. So the 8-speed transmission is new. And of course you get that on the entry-level trim as well. You don't have to move up a trim level to get some of those features, but that makes it just more drivability. It's a better transmission. I like it. It drives well. The other thing you're gonna notice is everybody who goes on trips in these vehicles, they love them for long trips. Now that 8-speed transmission, if you're driving over mountains or things like I've done on some major trips out east or even up north over Lake Superior, driving over mountains, having more gears is better and helps you with fuel economy, drivability, all kinds of things. Fuel economy numbers are very similar, but I think real-world fuel economy numbers are gonna be better on this car. That's an opinion of mine. I've done a fuel economy test on this and I think that's the way it is. But again, we're talking about facts, so don't take that as a fact, but do take reliability as a fact. Let's move to the side of the vehicle. We're gonna talk about some design details. We're gonna move our way to the back. We're gonna work our way inside. It's a full walk around of this car. I think people wanna know more about what you can get in an entry level minivan, and I think you might be surprised. So we're gonna take a look at the outside design and we'll work our way inside and talk about all the features. All right, so exterior design, let's go take a look. Basically, again, entry level, no options here at all. You still get signal lights in the mirrors out here, so you have those nice LED lights out here for signals. You don't have the alloy wheels on this, so it's the same size wheels as the LX or the LX Plus model, but the same size tires and wheels, but you have the wheel covers instead. That's a sacrifice you make. I don't think it matters to most people. I think they look fine. A lot of people are just looking for a minivan. They don't want all the frills and all that kind of thing. This one does a good job, but it doesn't look like a base minivan. You've got body colored door handles here as well. They never used to do that on entry level vehicles. And again, a nice clean design. You've got a spoiler out the back. You've got a sort of SUV look at the back. We're gonna look at that in a second, but a real clean design. That's what Kia is going for here. A little bit less minivan-like, a little bit more SUV-like, but let's be honest, it's a minivan and you're buying a minivan because it's super practical. Let's look at the back end and talk about that practicality. All right, the back end of the Sedona, you can see it's still a squared off look, that really SUV kind of look. You've got some detail here in the tail lights. Again, even on the entry level. The other thing is you have a chrome detail line here, not the black lines that you would have in other manufacturers' entry level vans. So the only real hint you have from the back that this is an entry level van is instead of having a model number here, like an LX or an SX, you just have nothing. So you have Sedona on that side and nothing on this side, but a sharp looking van nonetheless. You still got your spoiler up here like we talked about, different antenna, the shark fin style antenna up top. So it looks like a higher end vehicle. Gonna pop it open here. It's got an electronic button there to open up. You've got that deep, deep well down here. So again, these seats do fold flat on the floor. In fact, why don't I just take these floor mats out because the floor mats come with it as well. And we'll show you how they work. So we're gonna follow the lines here. First of all, there are headrests up here. We just put them down. Where we go? Pinch this one here, there we go. Put that all the way down. We're gonna fold that. Gonna pull this up and boom. you've got that flat floor. Now I'll show you how the middle row seats work in a second, but you've got that deep well here or the flat floor. You've also got a 12 volt socket here, so if you want to plug something in like a cooler or charge your computer, you do have power back here. And of course, you have your seat belts across here, a third row, one comes in the ceiling here, which comes down for the center row seat. So you've got three seat belts here. This is a 7-passenger van. It's the only other sacrifice you make, or you know, one of the sacrifices you make with the entry-level van. We have an 8-passenger van in the LX Plus, or sorry, the LX and above. So one step up from this van, you get 8 passengers, a couple more features, but a 7-passenger van is the way it comes in this L model. Let's go take a look at the side seats now. So the side doors on the L model are just manual doors, but they are weighted easily so they can be opened very, very easily. A couple fingers to open it up. Once you bring it back there, of course, it locks in place. Now these seats, everybody goes, oh, does it have stow and go like Chrysler? We don't. Now there's a few reasons for that. First of all, we have full size seats here. The stow and go seats are very small and very thinly padded. So Kia decided to go with something that is a much larger seat, much more comfortable for adults. It moves forward and back. There's all kinds of things you can do with it. You've got armrests here. You've got, you know, very, very comfortable seat. To get to the back, one lever flips it up. The other thing that does is gives you a completely flat floor behind there. Now, most people with minivans, if you're honest with yourself, you don't need that extra tiny bit of space that could be created by putting the seats in the floor. 95% of the time, probably 99% of the time, you're gonna have these seats up and they're probably gonna be filled with people. And in that case, you want bigger, more comfortable seats. So that's why Kia's gone with that. We think it's a good way to go with it. It works really well. And again, comfort is the real name of the game with these seats. Same seats here as you get in higher trim levels, so it's not like they're cheaping out in there. You have a fabric seat here, but it's called Yes Essential Fabrics. Basically what it is it's a stain-resistant fabric because we understand that minivans are gonna deal with families, and sometimes families spill things like drinks. So these are sort of stain-resistant seats, so you can spill some drinks on them and clean it up nice and easily. Lots of room to get to the back seats, easy to access there, and good cargo space here as well. And if you want to put it back, you do that, bring it all the way back. You've got lots of leg room. I'll show you what it's like to sit in there. Tons of space, tons of leg room, tons of headroom. We're going to talk about things like climate control that's standard back here, including the controls. You've got vents in the ceiling. So again, even though it's entry-level model, you still get a lot of things. Let's move to the driver's seat and we'll talk about features of this car. All right, so sitting in this van, there's a few things that I really like about it. First of all, you've got a tilt and telescopic steering wheel. So not just tilt, some people think they only have tilt on this level, but you have tilt and telescopic steering wheel. You also have a lot of adjustment. There's a height adjuster on the seat, which is a manual height adjustment. So basically what that means is if you're sharing this vehicle with two people of different sizes, you can always get comfortable. The seat, with the steering wheel and the seat move in a wide range of spaces. They're good size seats as well. So you can fit larger people, smaller people, works really well. I'm gonna put this a little bit further back just where it's comfortable for me. The big thing that people don't expect in this car is this 7-inch screen. Now, of course, every car has a backup camera now, and we have that as well. The big thing you're getting, though, is Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. So what does that mean? Well, that means that in this entry-level model that's about $5,000 or $6,000 less than some of our competitors' models, you get Android Auto, Apple CarPlay. You get navigation through your cell phone up on the screen here. Even little things, shout out to Sweet Bakery. I was going on Sunday night to Sweet Bakery in town here, and I could just hit my steering wheel control and say, what time is Sweet Bakery open until? And because my phone is connected up to Android Auto, Google tells me that Sweet Bakery is closed and I have to come back some other day. So that was out on Saturday night, I think it was. And lots of things you can do with Android Auto, Apple CarPlay, and of course it gives you the control from your steering wheel, from the screen here, and you have a nice big clear screen. So if you wanted navigation for your road trips, you've got that through your cell phone, but into the big screen here. It's better for sending text messages, you can stream music, all kinds of features. And the big thing with Android Auto and Apple CarPlay is they update like every other app on your phone. And when you get an update, you can see that update come to the screen here. So for navigation, you can use Waze. Even if you have an iPhone, you can use Google Maps now or Apple Maps. So tons and tons of features on that and always more being added. So I really like that. And you get it in this vehicle. We talked about the rear air conditioning. So climate controls, I'm gonna show you the climate control buttons here. And you've got two rows really. You've got the front row of climate control buttons and you've also got the rear row. Now you can lock that rear out. So in other words, if you have kids back there that are fiddling with the temperature controls, you can lock them out and control them all from the front. Or if you have adults back there or kids that you trust, then you can also use those and allow them to adjust their own temperature back there. So front and rear climate control, which is a good system here. It's just a manual system, easy to use. The other thing people don't expect is like some of the steering wheel controls here. You've got cruise control, you've got an information display and a digital display in the center here, and you've got options to control that from your steering wheel. You've got, what do we call it here? You've got audio controls on the left side. I'm losing it here. You've also got automatic headlights. Now, I've talked about those headlights before. I called them projector beam headlights. So what does that mean? Projector beam headlights, they look exactly like the front of a projector. And what they do is they give you a sharp cutoff line. So instead of scattering light everywhere from the cheap headlights, you used to see these only on higher end cars. They're not the crazy bright blinding lights, but even if they were blinding lights, that projector beam gives it a really sharp cutoff. So you've got normal halogen bulbs, but you've got a sharp cutoff, so it controls the light and spreads it exactly where you need it. Makes it easier to drive at night, and that makes it safer as well. So what else can we talk about? Little things, like you've got a little mirror up top here, which you can see your kids, so you don't have to adjust your mirror that you should be using for driving. You've got a convex mirror here, which you can watch everybody in the back and see them from the driver's seat. That works really well. Again, that nice cloth interior. They're all lighter cloth. Now, again, I mentioned the stain resistance of that, but it also brightens up the interior, makes it a more airy space, tons of headroom and stuff like that, but you've got that airy feeling, not just the airy or the open space around you. So you've got double glove boxes here, power windows, power mirrors, power locks. You've got a couple drive modes too, an active eco button. So if you hit that button, if you're driving efficiently, you can hit that active eco button. It'll change the way the car feels, the way it behaves. It just changes a bunch of computer programming, the way it shifts as well, and work with you to get better fuel economy. And that's sort of the mode I was talking about when I said I can exceed the fuel economy ratings on this car with that active eco. That 8-speed transmission makes it really drivable, gives you a lot of power. You can also tow with this car. You can tow 3,500 pounds. So if you're going camping and this is your family vehicle and you want to tow a trailer instead of just take tents, you can do that as well. So really, really practical vehicle. If you've watched this far in our video, maybe we've earned your business. If you're in the greater Toronto area, southwestern Ontario area, we want to earn your business on this vehicle. So give us a call, 519-304-6542. Visit our website, www.brantfordkia.ca. We want to try to earn your business on this vehicle. We do well with it. We do well with our videos online with this vehicle. And I think part of the reason we do well is because we understand the product and we want to work with you to help get you this product. So there you go. The Kia Sedona L for 2019.